Today at Guided Class, I get to review and do a product giveaway on one of these Soku folding solar chargers. If you're not watching on YouTube, head over to YouTube and search Guided Class Soku Solar for full details on how to win this. One lucky winner is going to win this thing for free, shipped straight from Amazon. I'm going to do a full sun test on this bad boy. We're going to take it outside and see just how many watts we can get in full sun. These are really great for camping, backpacking, boondocking, anywhere where you need 5-volt or USB power while on the go. This one here is a 22-watt version. I tend to find that these three-fold versions, they have six cells, output realistically anywhere from 12 to like 18 watts, but we're going to put that to the test here in a minute. They do make a four-fold version that goes up to like 25, 28 watts, but I find that the three-fold version is perfectly adequate to charge two power-hungry smartphones anywhere as long as you have full sun. So you got this little flap over here with the two USB ports. Each one you can output over an amp depending on how much sun you have. As soon as shade hits it though, you're pretty much screwed. I do recommend that you do not use this pocket over here for keeping your phone in while charging. In my testing with all the other brands that I've tested, this part just gets way too hot in the full sun. I would recommend putting your phone in the shade somewhere and setting this part out in the sun. But they are great and they do a great job. Let's take this thing out and see just how many watts we can get out of it. Got this thing pointed fully at the sun. We have pretty much clear skies. I've been waiting over a week for the sun to come out to do this video. But as you can see, it is a three-fold panel. Each fold has two cells each. Each cell puts out maybe 2 watts. So you got a theoretical max output of like 15 to 18 watts. Usually when they're selling these things, they like to put it up to 21, 22. But I usually see somewhere around 15 to 18 watts in full summer sun. So I've got a Bluetooth speaker hooked up. It's pulling about 0.9 amps, and I've got a constant current load resistor. It'll let me pull up to 2.5 amps constant current, and this thing will put out the 2.5 amps all day long, no problem. I had to hook up this extra speaker to get over the 2.5 amp mark, and basically we're pulling about 2.8 amps. We're charging here at 4.75 volts. I could actually turn this up a little bit to get down closer to the 4.5 volt mark, but this one is at 1.78, so about 1.8 amps, and this one is at 975, so about 1 amp. So we're pulling almost 2.8 amps there, and if you multiply the volts times the amps, you're getting up there closer. Can't do the math right now in my head, but probably about 15 amps. I'll do the math later and post it right here. So we're getting a pretty good output. 2.8 amps output at over 4.5 volts is definitely enough power to power two power-hungry smartphones. Anything you have that's USB capable, that's power-hungry, will be able to be powered by this, no problem at all. But as you can see, we've now lost our sun, and that's probably the last sun we'll have because we're supposed to be getting more rain for the next 3 days. So luckily I got this in, got about 2.8 amps, and that's very respectable. So if you want to win one of these, make sure you head over to the YouTube channel, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment on the video. And make sure you subscribe to the channel for more great videos. We're going to be giving away a lot of stuff in the next few months here. So make sure you hit yes for found this review helpful, and we'll see you on YouTube.